The island consists of a mountain range covered in glaciers and peaks of close to 3,000 meters or more than 9,000 feet. Some 50 million years ago, it was part of the Andes. And the journey to get there takes us 3 days. Our first destination will be Gold Harbor and the King Penguin colony located there. A combination of underwater topography and converging currents produce rich seas that support some of the largest seal, penguin and seabird colonies on the planet. Earlier in the season, we would have witnessed elephant seal bulls battling about the title as Beachmaster. These giants weigh up to 4 tons. In the previous episode, I mentioned Ernest Shackleton, who was on a rescue mission bound for South Georgia. The journey took them 16 days and they landed in King Haakon Bay on the unpopulated southern coast of the island. From there, they had to traverse 40 kilometers of uncharted, uninhabitable mountain range to reach Stromness. In this area, no decent safety officer could miss the chance to take the lifeboats out for a spin on such a beautiful day like this. The remnants of the whaling station that was abandoned in 1961. The stench during its active days must have been horrible, with up to 25 whales per day being butchered here. If the conditions allow, we beach the ship for easy access to the shore. This is the sight that Shackleton was facing when they finally made it across the mountain range and managed to get help for the rest of their men stuck on Elephant Island. And since the days of the Norwegian whalers and seal hunters, the seals and the penguins have no land predators, so they roam around fearlessly among visiting humans. As famous as South Georgia is for its abundant wildlife, it's infamous for its weather. And in combination with drifting glacial ice, it makes the navigation and the operations both exciting and sometimes a bit challenging.
That's when Zodiac cruising quite rapidly becomes more aviation and seafaring. So we are not going to be launching Zodiacs this morning. We are going to be staying on board the ship.
humbled, we leave South Georgia, bound for the Falkland Islands, also a British overseas territory. Alfred Lansing, the author of the book Endurance, one of the most famous accounts of Shackleton's journey, wrote, "Unlike on land, where courage and the simple will to endure can often see a man through, the struggle against the sea is an act of physical combat, and there is no escape. Thankfully, our ship is properly built for the task."
Sauce and precious strawberries and chopped mango. Oh. And also we have rock and roll ice cream tonight and raspberry sorbet.
My father, who is a big fan of the British bar culture, was on board as a guest and he had been looking forward to seeing Victory Bar.
You love the fast.
His only remark was that the package of cigarettes costed $17. We leave the capital, Stanley, bound for Carcass Island. The grim sounding name comes from the ship HMS Carcass, which surveyed the island in 1766. Finally, we do a ship cruise through the sound, the Woolly Gut, where you can sometimes experience strong currents. We are bound for an island that very few ships get the chance or the permission to visit. And after that, we will continue down to round Cape Horn in the next episode. Oh. Thank you.